Hello everyone and welcome to today's installment of Beyond the Mask. In today's episode, I'm going to be revealing everyone that dies in Halloween Ends and how they are going to be killed. This video leans heavily into spoiler territory, so if you don't want anything ruined, especially who is going to be killed off in the movie, then now may be the best time to check out, as I don't want you to watch this and then have regrets afterwards. This information comes from someone who saw one of the screenings for Halloween Ends, and most of their information has been 100% accurate so far, but as always, it could be a load of crap, so take it with a grain of salt. So let's get down to business. There isn't a specific number of people who die. Now, I'll explain the reason why as we go on. I'm gonna say roughly about 11 people are killed off in this movie. I don't have all the details on how they are killed specifically, but I know how they will die or why they die. So let's kick off straight away. Number one, the first on-screen death is the kid at the start of the movie, and I've done videos discussing the opening, but basically the movie introduces us to a new character, Corey Cunningham, who accidentally causes a kid he's babysitting to die. This sets up the movie going forward as Corey is scorned for his involvement in the child's death. Now, as we head into the first act, Corey comes across Michael Myers in the sewers of Haddonfield. Corey somehow becomes entranced by Michael's mask and loses all sense of himself. He then decides to go on a killing spree. So, number two, the second on-screen death is a police officer who is allegedly harassing Allison. He basically won't leave her alone and shows up as she's on a date with Corey. The officer completely ignores Corey's existence. Following Corey's descent into darkness, he plans on setting the cop up by leading him into the sewers where Michael is. This shot can be seen in the trailer. In this scene, Corey holds the police officer to the ground as Michael stabs him. Allison has been hoping for a promotion during this movie. She works as a nurse, but the promotion is given to someone who is actively having sex with her boss. So, number 3 and 4. Following the cop's death, Corey decides to take Michael with him to hunt down Allison's boss and co-worker. Corey wears a clown mask, I believe, to symbolise the beginnings of his spree, similar to Michael's in the first Halloween movie, and the pair killed the boss and co-worker. And you can see this in the clip from the trailer. This is the co-worker being pinned to the wall, and this is Michael, the real Michael, doing it. Now, following this death, Corey steals Michael's mask and on Halloween night decides to go on his own killing spree in Haddonfield. So number 5, this may not be in the right order, there's been conflicted reports, you know, about this. Apparently the first person that Corey kills during his killing spree, you know, alone, is his mother. She can be seen in the trailer and also in this promotional still. She's a pretty negative person in Corey's life. It holds a significance to Corey's story. Number 6, 7, 8 and 9. Corey experiences some bullies during the movie. They mock and ridicule him because of his involvement in the kid's death at the start of the movie. Now, this may happen actually before his mum dies, or it may happen after. Again, I've had conflicted reports, but apparently Corey takes revenge on the bullies and kills them one by one. During the confrontation, Corey's dad attempts to step in to help Corey, but one of the bullies kills Corey's dad. Corey, however, shows no emotion to his dad's death. Number 10, the next person to die is Corey himself. He goes head to head with Laurie Strode. I've done a complete breakdown video about this scene, but Corey stabs himself in an attempt to frame Laurie during the confrontation. The real Michael Myers shows up, collects his mask, which is this shot in the newest trailer. As he collects it, Corey makes himself known to Michael, but Michael allegedly dispatches Corey very, very quickly, and thus begins the war between Laurie and Michael. Number 11, the final death is Michael Myers himself. Again, a huge video with full details on this exists on my channel, and you can check that out. All the links to these videos are going to be in the description, so you guys can sort of find your way around. But Michael is stabbed in the face by Laurie Strode, and his body is torn apart by trucks in a junkyard as a symbolization of the destruction of evil. So that's all the alleged death scenes. I would say again, take this with a grain of salt. It still may be complete bullshit, but this is just a full breakdown for what I've been told based on someone who's seen the screening and has actually provided me with proof that they did, so I'm believing it myself, but don't you believe it, it could be a load of rubbish. I think it sounds good, death scenes are always important in any slasher movie. I have issues with this Corey plot, it seems so random to just sort of, you know, throw it in there. I'm sure I'm using the right word with random, you know, the sort of throwing the plot into the movie that takes away from Laurie and Michael's story. That being said, execution can sometimes be better than writing, so we will see what happens when the movie is out next month. What do you guys think though? Comment down below and let me know. As usual, thank you very much for watching this video, guys. Don't forget to like the video. That lets me know that you're enjoying this content. Closing off this video, I'm going to leave it on a moment from the new Halloween Ends trailer.
It's time to put the boogeyman to bed.
You like scary?